just wanted to get your blood pumping, which I did. Ha! All right. Now, let's get started. Rumps in chairs.
He's our teacher?
Okay. First, I'd like to introduce our new student, Tori. And I'd like to thank Tori for her generous gift of $2, which she handed me outside this morning. Not necessary, but much appreciated.
Hmm? Why'd you give him $2?
I thought he was homeless.
Now, today, we're going to continue our study in group improv. Tori, I assume you're familiar with improv.
No.
Okay. Crash course, improv. Acting without a script. Which means the actors must make up their own actions and dialogue as they perform the scene. Understood? Excellent. Jade, you will captain the first group of the day. Choose your actors.
Kat, Eli, Beck, and Tori.
Okay, let's give them a place.
Home.
Home.
Ooh, real creative.
You be quiet. Ow!
And now we need a situation.
Big news.
Andre, nobody wants to see big nudes.
News.
Ah, well, that's different. Big news!
Why don't you go wait in the hall?
Okay.
Okay, at home, big news and action.
Hey, babe, how was work today?
I got fired.
Again? It's okay. I have great news that'll cheer up this whole family.
What is it?
Tell us.
I went to the animal shelter and got us a dog.
Yep. I'm the new family dog. Woof.
Psychowitz, will you please tell this amateur that dogs can't talk and that they don't walk on two legs? Psychowitz!
Oh, I'm sorry. I was sucking the milk out of this coconut. But it's true, Tori. If you're gonna play a dog, be a dog.
Woof!
And action!
You see the bird too, right?
Yeah.
Fantastic.
One day when I was feeling low, I said to him, "Oh, bird. You can fly. You can soar miles from this lonely place, yet you stay. Why?
Why?"
And apparently my question rang true. For that afternoon, my bird left. And so went my spirit.
That was impressive.
So did I get it right?
Nope.
Right.
Tori, listen.
I'm not trying to be disrespectful, but do you know how hard I worked on the scene? I made this costume. I downloaded special prairie music. I even trained that crazy cockatoo to fly in and out of that window on command. Not now. Look, I know you're a great acting teacher and everything, but I don't care what you say. The scene I just did was good. And I'm proud of it, no matter what anybody thinks.
You just passed the bird seat!
But you said...
Tori, the whole point of the bird scene is to teach a performer like yourself to believe in your own choices, no matter what others think. We are artists, and a true artist does not define success based on approval from others. A true artist need only please himself or herself. Or its self.
You don't know what I got.
So all three times I did the scene...
were delightful. It was only wrong when you asked if it was right. Drive-by acting exercise. You're all elderly people walking barefoot on broken glass. Go! Terrified.
What did you do to my pants?
Falling off a cliff.
What did you do to my pants?
Excellent. Now, as you can see, the same dialogue can evoke an infinite number of emotions depending upon how the actor chooses to play it. Like a robot.
What did you do to my pants?
Wrong! Robots don't wear pants. It was a trick. Tori, you may sit. I suggest using a chair.
I'll give it a shot.
Okay, everyone, we have 20 minutes before our play begins. Where is my coconut milk?
You're drinking it.
So am I.
Rex!
Rex!
It's one of you.
Is he okay? Is Rex okay?
No, 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 no!
What did you do?
I just
Rex! Rex, can you hear me? Oh. 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 Is that you, Rob?
Robbie's here. It's me. It's okay.
I'm busted up pretty bad.
I've got to get into the hospital.
Robbie?
I've got to!
Robbie! You're starring in this play. The audience is outside waiting to come in. It's your job to entertain them, no matter what.
Oh, I feel cold.
All right, nice work, everyone. Wait, Tori, Andre, Beck, Jade, Kat, Robbie. Stay for a moment.
Why do you have a woman's purse?
I don't have a... Good Gandhi, where did this come from? And where's my dozen bagels?
Can I leave?
Wait. How would you teenagers like to do something for money?
Can we have some details first?
Well, I assume you're all familiar with Kevin Chase.
The guy who owns like half the hotels in Vegas?
I'm telling the story.
Sorry.
Kevin was my roommate in college, and now he's extremely wealthy, and his little boy is turning 4 years old this week. The big 04.
What do you want, man?
Kevin hired the Wagafuffles to perform a song at his son's birthday party.
Oh, I love the Wagafuffles!
Wagga, 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 wag your fuffle left and right. Wagga, 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 wag your fuffle day and night.
Shut up!
Rex told me to shut up.
Yes, thank you, Rex.
I'll give you this dollar to get to the point.
I couldn't possibly take your money. Apparently, the Wagafuffle's private jet crashed. And so now Kevin needs a new musical group to perform at his son's birthday party.
So you want us to form a kiddie musical group?
For just one performance.
No.
He'll pay you $1,000.
$1,000?
Shall I tell my friend you're all in?
Where would we do this?
I'll set up the party here at school, in the Black Box Theater. You can perform on stage after the kids have their cake and ice cream. It'll be fantastic.
There you are.
Ah, my bagels. Sorry about the mix-up there.
Pull your head out of your pants.
Bye, Mom!
That was your mom?
No. All right, children. How many of you like a musical group called the Wagafuffles?
Yay!
Yes! Well, they're not here. Be like that? Mm-hmm.
I heard the Wagafuffles airplane fell on a mountain.
Anyway, the important part is we have a brand new musical group to do a song for you today. All right. I give you the Diddly Bops.
Hi, kids!
Welcome to the Green Meadow Mall.
A good place to shop.
I'm a hot dog.
Something's wrong here.
What I like about cheese is that you can put it on veggies and it tastes.
Mm-hmm.
good.
Yeah!
I like to talk about food.
Those aren't the real diddly bops.
Yeah. We are too, the diddly bops.
They're fakers. That guy's like 100 years old.
I'm 34. Drinks, chips, dip, nuts, and liquid soap. Party time! Well, I wonder who'll be arriving first. Well, hello there.
I am a police officer! Would you like some raisin bran?
No, thank you, but please, come in.
Sure.
And your name is?
Officer Podesco. Do you have anything sharp and a pointy in your pockets that could injure me?
I certainly hope not.
Doorbell!
I'll answer it.
Okay.
Ah, good evening. Come in.
Thanks. Thank you. Woo!
Yes, thanks for welcoming us into your fine home. But don't forget to thank yourself. Because if you just believe in yourself, there's nothing you can't do.
Hey, I'm pregnant. I just ran 26 miles. Can I please get some water?
Of course, it's right over there.
Okay.
I didn't catch your name.
Oh, I'm sorry, I was just admiring your fine animal statuettes. I'm Kevin Kornblum, motivational speaker. I've devoted my life to helping teens. Oh, there go the legs.
Are you all right?
I'm right as rain. Thank you for asking.
Turn 21. We got a man down. Caucasian male, glasses afro, possibly Jewish. Can I offer you some raisin bran?
No, thank you, officer.
Man, I'm so tired. I'm pregnant. I gotta sit down.
Please, take any seat.
Thanks.
Ooh. Yes! Just believe in your dreams, and you can sit in any chair. Anywhere.
Yeah, okay.
Doorbell!
I'll get it!
What I want to know is what part of the chicken do the nuggets come from? Can someone tell me this, please? I mean, where's the wacky farm that raises nugget chickens?
Hilarious observations. Kids, it's getting late.
I'll never forget the time. I was having kippers for breakfast, and a musty old burger flew right over my head.
This method acting exercise is becoming tedious.
Raisin bran was invented by Kevin McRaisenberg and Jack McBran.
I beg you to go home.
So you're reminiscent of a flippity-jibber with a nosher kiwi and a lardy bit for the squabble.
I can't take it anymore. All right! Since it's obvious, neither one of you are going to be breaking character anytime soon, and I can't stand being here with either one of you anymore. I'm going to bed. You can help yourself to anything in the refrigerator, but please do not look in the cabinet under the sink in my bathroom. Please. And I'm very proud to announce the newest member of the Hollywood Arts ping pong team, Tori the Paddle Puss Vega! Now, wish us all luck, and hopefully we'll bring home yet another first place trophy for Hollywood Arts! All team members, in my van! Thank you. Thank you.
Hey, look at that! Shag Comedy!
like a farmer planted a lobster and a potato in the same hole. Maybe it would grow a lob-tato.
Yes, Kat. A lob-tato would grow. I'll tell the farmers.
Here's your check.
Thank you. What the hairballs?
What?
It's $1,300.
No, that's much.
It's never been over 700.
Way to go, Tori.
I ordered the same thing you did.
Wait, wait, I see the problem. They mistakenly charged us an extra $600 for caviar.
Oh.
Excuse me, sir.
Hi, is anything wrong?
Yes. We were mistakenly charged for $600 worth of caviar.
Oh, that's not a mistake. That awkward young man ordered a large bowl of caviar.
Man, what were you thinking?
Hey, I didn't order any caviar.
Robbie!
I didn't know it was that expensive!
Robbie can't help what he is. Nevertheless, we don't have enough money to pay the check.
Well, sir, I'm sorry, but payment is required, or I'm going to have to call the police.
The police? Let's talk about our hopes and dreams. Tori!
Psychwits!
What's your biggest hope and or dream?
Probably to be a pop star. A really successful singer. What?
Well, maybe you could sing at weddings. For the hearing impaired.
Okay, this is the most fun class ever. You really don't think I can make it as a singer?
Nope. Ha! You see? You're all staring at me with rapt attention. Why? Because as a teacher, you expect me to encourage my students not puke on their dreams. Right?
Right.
Uh-huh.
This is what I was trying to explain. When characters do the unexpected, audiences pay attention.
So I said okay.
Really? I had no idea you did stunt work.
I don't. I'm not a stunt double.
Then why'd you accept the job?
I don't know, because I'm stupid.
I've been telling you people she's stupid, but did anyone believe me?
All right, wait, why'd they even offer you a job as a stunt double?
Because of my resume. Under special skills, I put gymnastics and karate, and that made them think that I could do stunts.
See, you should never lie on your resume. Well, that's not a pretty face.
Will you please just call your casting director friend and get me out of this?
You might not want to do that.
Why not?
You want to get blackballed in Hollywood?
What do you mean, blackballed?
In this town, everybody knows everybody.
You make people mad, word gets around.
And then no one will hire you.
Great, so what do I do? Get blackballed or do a stunt and get my face smashed?
I think you should do both.
You know,
stunt doubles rarely get injured.
Yeah, but...
And you told them you'd do it.
Which is a commitment. And making a commitment is like, well, take this coconut, for example. Brown, spherical, covered with short, fibrous hairs that... What were we talking about?
Please.
Why?
Guys, I'm mad at myself for chickening out. I feel like a weenie.
The world needs weenies. Without weenies, who'd wear turtlenecks?
I gotta do this stunt.
Look, why don't you just...
Come on, just call your casting director friend and get us on the set, please.
Very well.
Yay! Thanks.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, why are you upside down?
Why are you right side up?
Hey, Sykowitz.
Hey, Vega.
How are we gonna do this performance if Andre's sick?
Relax! He's with a Yerbanian doctor right behind that stained sheet.
Ow.
Come, let's check on him.
Hello. I don't like that. Okay, where's the doctor?
That's him. There.
What, the boy? He's like 11.
Almost 12.
How is he, Doc?
That boy is not a doctor.
No, but he is the doctor's son.
You! You people!
What?
Who misses their favorite teacher? You have to act like I'm a Yerbanian prison guard.
Right. Where did you get that outfit?
They sell these at the hotel gift shop. How stupid is that?
Would you just get us out of this prison?
I'm working on that.
You have a plan?
Sort of. I've got a duck truck.
A duck truck?
Yes. I met a farmer and offered him 100 schwartels to let me borrow it.
I joined the prison gang.
Oh, Kat. You are delightfully filled with joy and stupidity.
It's all that, Captain Alfredi. Little salmon, oh.
Curtain! Curtain! We'll be taking a brief intermission.
Poor Tori.
Yeah. I'll go get her dress off.
No!
She can't play the role, and I'm the understudy.
I don't care. You've been acting like a gank all week. I'm not going to reward you by letting you play the lead.
There's an audience out there. The show must go on.
Yes. Yes, it must. And must it shall.
You can't captain the boat. You're just a woman.
I might be a woman. That doesn't mean I'm not the best dang steamboat captain this here river's ever seen.
Now, men will always tell you how they do it all. And women do the work you never see. So as it would happen, you're in great need of a captain. Whoa! Captain, and that captain is me.
And so as it would happen, we're in great need of a captain. Well, a captain, yes, a captain is she.
Did they get the Pontiac out of Robbie?
They sure did, Tori.
I had dreams of doing something special with my life. But now I'm just a high school teacher. Worthless loser. Frittering my days away in a stupid classroom with a bunch of snot-nosed teenagers? That's no life for a man!
Okay, so look at teaching as a temporary thing.
It's been 10 years, Randy. 10 years! Watching my friends have rewarding lives while I'm nothing but a stinking high school teacher.
Great play, Tori. Good call. I didn't know.
At least you're not bald. Mike?
Dude. Come on, buddy.
Oh. Hi.
Oh.
Hey!
why.
So, Psychowitz, what you gonna teach us today, I mean, I don't know what to expect, but I bet it's gonna be fantastic. Woo! All right.
Huh?
We're ready to learn.
Yeah, okay. Tori. And, Elvis. Get up on the, stage thing.
Okay.
Sure.
All right. What you, want us to do?
A scene. You both have the same line. Life is pain. So you just keep saying that to each other over and over. Do it, action.
Life is pain.
Life is pain.
It certainly is, Ding. There's the bell, class dismissed.
Way to go, Tori. You broke Psychowitz.
I did not break Psychowitz. I did not break Psychowitz.
Can I ask, what is this film about?
I've asked her that 5 times.
And action!
Jessica, I feel so lonely.
Oh, Robert, why?
Because I'm alone.
No man should ever be alone.
You look beautiful in this moonlight.
Her hair.
What?
That's the line where you stroke her hair.
You forgot to stroke it.
Right. You look so beautiful in this moonlight. Oh, Jessica, you kissed.
Hey, cut. Come here.
Okay, so what do you think of her?
Why do you keep doing this?
What?
During every audition, you stop the scene right after the kiss, then yank me aside to ask me what I think.
Because I trust your opinion about...
Are you trying to find a woman for me to date? The truth.
Okay, yes.
Good Gandhi, why would you think I would
need... the lady you've been dating moved away and you've been so sad and depressed about it.
Tori, I'm not depressed because I miss Catherine.
Then why have you been all...
I miss her pet, Bunny.
Her pet?
Mm-hmm. Cutest little creature you ever saw. Used to sit on my lap. Hop around the apartment. Such a silly...
Knock, knock, he's coming! Hurry,
no! Okay, Bunny. Don't move.
Well, my goodness. You've scampered far from home, haven't you?
Psychowitz?
Hi.
Hello.
So, what you got there?
Well, I found this little rabbit just wandering about.
Aw, how cute.
Isn't she?
So, why don't you take her home?
Oh, I'm not into rabbits.
But you've been depressed for days because you miss your ex-girlfriend's Bunny.
Well, yes, but... Oh, you thought Bunny was a rabbit.
Well... Yeah.
No. Bunny's a cat.
A cat?
Yes. The woman I was dating named her cat Bunny after her Aunt Bunny, who's dead.
But you told me it hopped all around.
Yes. She only had 3 legs. Poor kitty.
He loved her cat.
Very much. But I'll get over it. Well,
Back to the wilderness you go.
Okay, so here's the new plan.
No.
Do you see anything?
I see a guy on the sidewalk petting a little dog. Wait, no. It's a giant rat. And he's not petting it. He's eating it. I'm gonna shut this. What time is it?
Almost 3 a.m. And what time do we have to check into the parade bar?
7 a.m.
Which means we have to be there in... Wait, let me do it over again. 4 hours! 4 hours.
Yeah, hi. We have a flat tire. Could you please send a tow truck? Great, thank you so much. We're on the corner of Spates and 83rd. Yeah, how long do you think it'll take for you to... Hello? He hung up!
Man, nobody's gonna drive into this neighborhood at night.
Hey, Batman would.
Do you have Batman's phone number?
No.
Then how are we gonna call Batman?
We're not.
Oh, no, we're not!
All right. I think there's a 24-hour price go on Spates. I'll jog up there, buy a tire, and be back in 30 minutes.
You sure you want to be running through this neighborhood at 3 a.m.?
The only thing I'm afraid of is fear. And the guy who installed my satellite dish. I know he wanted to hurt me.
There used to be a cell phone tower right up there.
What kind of sicko steals a cell phone tower?
Oh, thank Cheddar. Oh, officers, I am so glad to see you.
Yeah.
Where are your pants?
They were taken by hooligans. They jumped me about a quarter mile back that way.
And what you doing running around this neighborhood in the middle of the night, huh?
Oh, well, I was on my way to the parade, riding along with a bunch of children in a giant cupcake.
Uh-huh.
Now, next thing I know, one of the cupcake's tires goes pop. And why are you taking out your handcuffs? I don't understand what's happening. Why are you arresting me? There are 7 children in a cupcake who need me. Help!
There's no children in a cupcake.
Yes! They're wearing candy pajamas. Help! Help me! Freedom!
Hi, Christmas Bee.
Just give me anyone else.
Jade, you're Tori's secret Santa, and that be that.
Why do I have to?
He said he's not gonna change it, so just deal with it. Why don't you just deal with it? Why don't you just deal with it?
His heart is vibrating. How much coffee have you drunk?
A lot, like a lot. I don't know, like maybe 7 cups. A lot. Is there a problem?
He's drinking coffee to stay awake at school because of the stupid cricket that's keeping him up every night.
A lot of coffee.
Look, I don't want to be Tori's secret Santa.
Too bad. Is that a cricket?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Can I have it?
Sure.
Courtney, Merry Christmas from your secret Santa. Light a candle, Burf. This place stinks.
I don't have a candle.
Then get a better haircut.
Shake it off, Burf. He's just in a mood.
You girls are ruining this play.
Why?
Andre, Beck, take 5. This is our 5th rehearsal, and you two aren't getting any better at playing a believable husband and wife. Burf, be quiet! You girls meet me for dinner at Nozu tonight, 7 p.m.
But I don't want to go.
Nozu!
What? Why? You can't.
Oh,
at least let us.
See you both at Nozu at 7 p.m.
Hey, my audition is next Tuesday.
So?
So, tell me what was so bad about my acting in the scene.
Look, you're a good actor, but you're still playing the scene too safe.
Totally agree.
You're supposed to be a troubled teen girl on the edge. And to play that kind of emotion, you can't just be your usual prissy little Tory.
Prissy? The bird died. My throb got in his eyes and he flew into a roller coaster.
You want to get this role? You need less press and more risk. Make us believe you're dangerous. On the edge.
Okay, okay. I'm dangerous. Risky. Okay, let's do it. Go. Action.
Lana, just tell me why you tried to push your uncle off that cliff.
You ask me one more question, I'll rip that pencil out of your hand and stick it right in your neck! Okay, that does it! Mr. Purples!
Hey, Psych, what's for our homework assignment? Do you want us to... Good luck to you.
Children, kids, I can tell you how Trina got into Hollywood arts.
You know?
Mm-hmm. I was at her audition 4 years ago.
So, are you gonna tell us?
Oh, yeah. So, just before Trina's audition was about to begin, Principal Eichner walked into the room. Okay, who's auditioning next?
Hey, you guys, that weird kid, Jensen?
Senjen?
Yeah, he got his face stuck in the soda machine again. Can you come help me pull it out? It's like, what's, you stay here, continue with the auditions.
Right.
What's that?
Oh! It's a special coconut my cousin sent me from Sri Lanka. I'm gonna drink its milk.
It smells kind of weird.
Yes, it was delivered to my back door, so I didn't see it for 3 weeks.
Maybe it's spoiled.
Maybe, but I'm still gonna drink its milk.
Yeah, but, I gotta. Okay, Sinjin, I'm coming.
All right, next.
Hi, I'm Trina Vega.
Hello, Trina. Ooh, that's a funky taste. All right, Trina, take it away.
Can't stop, you know I'll never give it up.
Oh, I think this coconut milk is affecting me. Oh, yes. Sweep my toes and look what she can do. Oh, look. Now she's a hot dog. I love hot dogs. Oh, sing hot dog. Trina is in. Trina is in. Trina is in. Trina is in. And after seeing that, I accepted Trina into Hollywood arts.
What happened?
What's going on? Fawn Leibowitz!
Oh, shut up, hippie!
She never liked you.
You all right, kid?
Yeah, thanks, Gary.
Sure. I'll text your mom. Let her know you're okay.
Good.
She's a special lady.
Thanks.
No, she didn't get expelled from Hollywood Arts to make room here for you.
Then why did she get kicked out?
She's crazy. A loony bat. She stole things, carried weird stuff in her backpack, called everyone Debbie. A real nutcase.
Lick my loafers, Debbie.
Hey, be careful with her. She's a slippery one.
Oh. I fell asleep during study hall. Jade found me.
Oh, don't be sad, little one. I think your head looks great like that.
Of course you do.
Jade, you're late. Go to the janitor's closet.
Oh, right.
Hey. Wait, what's happening in the janitor's closet?
Just make sure you're there in the next 60 minutes. Oh, being attacked! Great, just take it! Get it off me! Get it off me! Hurry. Let's take a look at this performance by me from an old TV show called City Bus Nights. There I am, guest starring as the character of Loogie. So, for my backstory...
Hi, sorry to interrupt.
What is it, boy?
Mason Thorne Smith is having a major press conference right now about the Platinum Music Awards.
I got it. They're streaming it on the Slap.
Put it on the TV.
Okay. Now let's see. W.
Mom! Oh my God, that's insane.
Excuse me?
Oh, hey.
We were just watching a video.
Yeah, these two horses are...
Put your phones away. We are rehearsing a play.
Right.
Our bad.
Hey, send me the link to that video.
Stop that! Jade, let's go from your line. Jade?
What's up?
Jiminy crackers, I'm trying to teach you kids something about...
One sec. Oh. Grandma, what is it? No, nobody stole your bed. You're just in the kitchen.
Hang up that phone right now.
Take your pills.
Getting sick and tired of... Oh, what now?
Oh, I just texted everyone a pic of me. That's my sister's shirt I'm wearing.
Why?
That's so weird.
All right, that does it. That tears it!
What?
You people are sick!
I feel pretty good.
I'm talking about your addiction to your stupid phones. I swear to Pete, you can't go 2 minutes without... Blah, blah, blah.
Oh, come on. I don't think it's fair to say we're addicted to them.
Yay! Oh,
turn around.
Come on,
Ronnie. Show your scoop of hair.
Yes!
That's it, everybody. The boys win! Oh!
Was over.
No, I believe I said, if you want your phones, take them.
You didn't say anything about the contest being over.
Wait. No. The guys, you guys all got your phones too.
Off.
Off?
Off. You girls turned yours on.
Boom, yeah.
Okay.
And what?
Cyclists?
Yes.
You were in on this with them? You helped the boys trick us.
Absolutely.
But why?
Look, this turned into a contest between the boys and the girls. Now, I may be an educator and I may be your friend, but first and always, Erwin Cyclewitz is a boy.
Oh. 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 Oh.
Have you seen an unholy woman with a horrible little girl?
Mr. Cyclewitz!
Oh, dear!
Mr. Cyclewitz, I see you there.
Mrs. Hilbert, Isn't it bad enough that I have to live across the street from you and your vicious little daughter? Must you bring her to my place of work?
I brought her here to apologize for what she did this morning.
What'd she do?
None of your stupid business.
I'll tell you what she did. This morning I was showering with my bathroom window open, and this little egg chucker nailed me in the head.
It ain't my fault your head broke my egg.
I will end you.
You say you're sorry.
No.
Say it.
You say it.
Rhonda!
I'm sorry.
Thank you. And I hope you've learned you have to show adults some degree of respect. You can't just... Oh!
Rhonda! Not nice!
Come back here! I will get you if it's the last thing I... Great jeepers, I think my leg is broken.
It's the flower bomber! Why he's doing this? Poor Psychowitz.
He looks like a big hairless donut.
Mr. Psychowitz! Mr. Psychowitz!
What do you want?
For you to drop the charges against my daughter.
Yes, Psychowitz.
They're gonna put my baby in juvie.
I told you if she threw one more egg at me, I would contact the police. And last night, she egged me right in the tummy.
I was aiming lower.
She did that?
Who asked you, chicken hips?
Watch it, strawberry grunge cake!
That tears it!
Ow! Get off of me! Stop! Hey! No! What is she doing? Stop! Stop!
Have you no manners?
Have you no hair?
Bus.
I see. All right. No bus play. No underwater musical. Why don't we all just lay on the floor and stick our faces in the carpet? Thusly.
What do you
say?
I think he said Robbie's mother sprays his underpants with bug spray.
Rex, my mom, she's just worried that I've got roaches.
I think Psychowitz is sad.
I'm not sad. Just disappointed in you children.
Why?
Because you're all a bunch of negative Nancys. Whiny Willies, depressing Darnells. Ah.
Oh, I know an old man named Parnell. His wife says things to him like, "Hey, Parnell, you want to eat some pancakes on a rocket ship?"
Nobody ever knows what you're talking about.
You have man breath.
What are you bugging about?
I'll tell you about what I'm bugging. When you kids started this class, you were all bright-tailed and bushy-eyed, hungry to learn about being performers. Now, you don't want to do nothing. I might as well just quit. I should just walk out that door, never to return. Your favorite teacher, exiting forever!
Okay, okay, don't quit, just... What do you want us to do?
Be more open-minded.
Hey, Andre!
Oh! Hey, Posey.
Can I ask you something?
Oh.
See... I need help writing a song for my creative songwriting class.
Well, good luck. Oh, shit. You are freakishly strong.
That's because I drink lots of tomato juice. Do you like tomato juice?
I don't think anyone does.
Going somewhere?
Yeah, I just had a bran muffin, something.
Posey, were you about to ask Andre to do something?
Will you help me write a song, please?
Yes. Yes, I will.
Excellent.
I reserved the music room for 6 o'clock tonight. See you there.
Yes.
Oh, you want me to bring you some tomato juice?
Yes.